Hi, this is Brad from Static Void Academy, and today we're going to be talking about web servers and web applications. Before we proceed to the matter at hand, I'd like to refer you to the Medium article we've written right here.
Also, here's our extra large article.
We also have a repository hosted on GitHub that'll contain all the code that we'll reference. We assume you have a GitHub account and you know how to clone repositories. We assume you have Python 3 installed, as well as pip, the package manager, and pip env. We also assume that you know that the three amigos and the Denver Broncos were the three greatest wide receivers ever assembled.
Wait, what?
If you don't have any of these installed, we've included a README in our GitHub repository that will show you how to install all of them. There's a lot to be confused about when you first start looking at web apps and web servers, including why the Python Flask logo looks like a Christmas pepper. You'll find a lot of complicated definitions about them, but at their core, web applications and web servers merely allow people to discover data or content online. You're able to watch this video because it's hosted on a YouTube server somewhere, and your browser or whatever you're watching it on knows where to access that data. Now let's take a look at the simplest and dumbest example of a web server. Go ahead and take the text that you see on screen right now and type it into a text editor and save it as index.html. Once you've saved that file, you should be able to double-click it and see the HTML you wrote displayed in a web browser. This is the pure distilled essence of a web server. We created data and then we found it. So now you're probably thinking, wow, I found a file I wrote. That's amazing. And it actually is amazing because following this very simple paradigm, it allows billions of people the world over to access terabytes of data. Now let's add another page to your dumb fake web server. Go ahead and copy the text you see on screen now and save it in the text editor as about.html. Now you notice if you double click on this file that first off the path in your web browser is different to accommodate this new file, and also you'll see a blue link that if you click it will redirect you to the original file we wrote. This concept is referred to as routing, where we provide different content to visitors based upon the path they request. Why don't we call it pathing? I don't know. So right now all we've created is a scavenger hunt for ourselves. We create material and then we find it. But what if we could let the entire world know where to access our data? And that's what web servers do. Web servers like Apache or Nginx will take certain directories on your computer that host static files like the ones we've written and will make them accessible on a port on your computer so people from outside can access that data. Now on the screen right now you can see a high-level diagram of what happens when a web browser requests content from online. If you don't understand it, just grab your chin and nod along. It begins by typing in a request in plain English. But robots don't speak English, they speak numbers. So this request goes to a DNS server that is translated into an IP address where that resource can be found. The computer that is sitting at this IP address will have an instance of Apache, Nginx, or another similar web service running that will intercept this request and then will handle it by retrieving the piece of information it's requesting. Now you're thinking, hey, that makes sense and is very simple. And now comes a more important lesson in software engineering. It's always harder than you think. This paradigm works great if you have two text files sitting on your desktop that you're clicking between. But do you think Facebook has a static file for all women named Brenda? No. This information is generated dynamically upon request. This is what a web app is. Let's take a look at our GitHub repository, where we can find a Python file that implements a Flask web server. Now, if you follow along the README included in the repository, you should be able to easily download all the dependencies required to launch the web application. If you have any trouble, go ahead and comment below or comment on the accompanying Medium article. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at our Python file. And in the first several lines, you'll see that we're merely doing boilerplate library inclusions. But on line 6, we define our first route. The slash indicates that we are at the root of our web application, and if anyone navigates to this slash, they'll receive hello world. To make sure I'm not completely lying to you, let's go ahead and give that a shot. Now you can see that this is very similar to what we did at the beginning of this video with static HTML files on our desktops. And just like that example, you can see that this is worthless. Now, to show you the worth of this, I went ahead and tried to anticipate all the questions you'd have. Here they are, in order. Brad, can I pass parameters in the URL? Brad, are there multiple ways to pass parameters in the URL? Brad, can I specify which method I want to use for my URL? Brad, can I place a type constraint on the parameters in my URL? And Brad, who are the three amigos? Just like everything in this video, all these examples are varying degrees of stupid. However, if you imagine replacing the plain text name and age we're displaying with graphs of data or streaming videos, then you'll start to see the power of web applications. I'd like to thank you again for taking your time to watch this video, and I hope you got something out of it regarding web applications and web servers. And if you had any difficulty whatsoever downloading anything or getting anything to run, then go ahead and make sure you comment, because we want to resolve these as soon as possible. And also, we'll be putting out weekly content, so if you like what you saw, make sure you like and subscribe so you'll be notified when we release new videos. Thank you again, and this has been Brad from Static Void. As soon as you've typed that and saved it, you should be able to double click on it. I'm talking really slow. And now we'll take a look at some of these. Speaking of stupid web apps, I direct you to the link included in our video that's up my ass. Thank you again, and this has been Void from Static Brat. Oh, wait. Before we... Okay, fuck. Oh, God.